Hi, my name's Notion. I'm valued at over $3 billion and I don't have a Google Calendar sync. Yeah, that's a problem. Good news is, I find everything. I found a Google Calendar sync. Let's go check it out. So this is not a joke. You actually will find that at notionautomations.com, you will be able to do a full Notion to Google Calendar sync. So this website's actually kind of new, and from what I understand, they're actually going to try to bring in other upcoming automations like Google Sheets, Slack, some email stuff, Trello, Todoist, all these different workflows. Hopefully we'll get into the type of sync that you want it to have. But if you'll see, when I go here and press start syncing now on notionautomations.com, so I actually did this as a test earlier and I'm gonna show it on video. So if I go to connect my Google Calendar, essentially I have my admin.riseproductive email. If I go into here, I know I've already accessed this. That was me. So as we'll see, if I press this and I hit connect, what do I want to connect to it? So I have my personal calendar here. I have my Calendly here. I have my Rise Productive here. So if I go here and select what I want, the main reason for this is going to be I want to connect my Calendly so that I don't have to deal with all the constant, like, okay, when do I have to do this? When do I have to do this? So we hit continue. Then we go to duplicate the premium Notion template. So they actually make a nice Notion template for you to use as an example here. And you can use your own as well. But if we go here and press duplicate and you duplicate it to your workspace, and you can actually exit out of this and go to your actual Notion and it should be there. So it'll be called agenda. If you go here, it's connected right here. So then what I would do is I would go to the bottom, go to this database area, right click, copy the link to events, then go to continue to connect Notion. And then I'm going to press edit here just to show you that basically what you're going to do is you're going to have to press connect, press select pages. Then you can press this agenda page right here, allow access. And what you can do is actually see that it'll find the database events. And then the next part is, are there events you do not want to sync? Yes, there are some events I don't want to sync. Event title contains Dimitri RP. So if it says Dimitri RP, I do not want that in there. I have a weekly, like some sort of task that I consistently do where it's just like my focused work on my Google Calendar. And that's more of a time blocking thing than an actual event. So that's something that I don't want always coming up on my Notion, because it's like, I don't need the time blocking here. I just really want events like meetings and whatnot with my Calendly. So then you could also get rid of all day events. You can get rid of things that have no attendees, which would make sense, you know, if it's not an attendee, but I do have some tasks on there that I would like to sync up with my Google Calendar. So recurring events is an option as well. So I think this is a good one if you just want it to be calls with people and you don't want without, if you don't want people to not be a part of it, that would be a great one, especially for people who just want Calendly links. And or if things have a certain event, and there's just so many different advanced conditions. So if you press that advanced thing, ignore events matching. So I actually can go to my Google Calendar for you and see what I'm talking about. I don't want this to sync with this. And if I had my personal one, I could go through all of my personal one. And then basically for what's my basic personal layout, then it wouldn't sync. So then what I could do is be like, okay, so basically when I have an ad hoc thing, like go hang out with the guys and I have a time for that, then I would at least have it on my Notion and my Google Calendar as a task and an event. So that'd be nice, as well as like, I could sync it so that I could have this showcase so I can remember to do it on my Notion as well as my Google Calendar. But you know, some things are repetitive. So we don't always need to do everything in the exact same way. As you can see for the Rise Productive calendar, if we take my personal one off, you know, I don't know if I really want to sync, or I do want to sync Dimitri Systems Improvements, and I do want to sync Plan Week. So that's why I'm leaving those there. So at this point, I think we're pretty good to go. If I go back to the Notion automations, hit continue. One last thing, do you want to automatically append the Notion page link to your event description? That would basically be like, it takes the Notion page link and puts it in your Google Calendar description so that I can sync up the notes, sort of. So I can press yeah. Now let's test it out. Let's test the sync. And basically what it's gonna do is check your calendar connections, sync to Google Calendar, and when you go back to that agenda page in Notion, it'll sync everything up for you. boom, we just sync 9 calendar events into your Notion, for example, the podcast recording, which is awesome. This is something that I always have to like fix in Google Calendar and in Notion, and I don't want to have to do that anymore. So if I press continue, so you can see here, this is basically how it's going to work. You have your different things in your calendar that pop up. Now, I will admit that this filtering is not working as well as I'd like it to. So actually, let's do a test really quick. If I go here to this week, go to this Friday, delete this. If I go to Google Calendar, let's try to move this to 5:30 a.m. I refreshed and actually it will sync Google Calendar to the Notion experience. So I moved the time in Notion and it moved it in Google Calendar. So if I go back here and change it to 5 a.m., what will it do when I go back into Notion? As you can see, boom, it's at 5 a.m. in Notion. Now, I will admit that that filter I put on it where it says it's not gonna sync things that are Dimitri RP, that's not working. So I will say maybe the filtering on this could be a little bit better. I'm sure that there could be some user error on my end, but regardless, as you can see, I just gave you an example and I can go here and go side by side screen-wise and show you another example of how this is actually directly syncing to my Google Calendar. So if I go here, let's make this clearly different, 10:15 a.m. And then in the software, after you sign up for it, it'll sync, you know, every few minutes. So if I do a manual sync, it changed it to 10:15. Now, obviously, if I had waited 2 minutes, it would have gone through, but I'm recording a video. Now, I will admit that this application is $5 a month or $50 for an entire year. And this is the dashboard you'll get once you pay for it. So you can obviously go and get that with the link in the description. But as you can see, there's a lot of nice functionality. You can actually take the different Notion fields that you want from Google Calendar. So obviously the event name, you can go to the name of Notion. So this is the calendar that you're working with Google-wise. And you can say what different things that you want. You can actually put a different view on how far out you want to go regarding the sync setting. So it'll be 15 days ahead. Add Notion URL. You can do sync pre-existing Notion entries. So you can go back and bulk sync things up or bulk delete calendared events or unsync different calendars. Obviously, like I said, the mapping is really cool. You can do things like get the conference call link in Notion. You can only put as much or as little as you want. So I probably will go through and do this with my own personal calendar and sync it up in a nice way so that it works for Rise Productive and my personal work as well. What's really cool about this template they give you and what I could probably do with my own contacts database is it actually syncs contacts. So if I go and see it here, there's a contacts database that shows all the different contacts that I have and how many events that I have with them. So it's filtered by where this involved this week number is greater than zero. So it takes a formula, I'm sure. This involved this week is a formula that basically calculates, it concatenates involved this week in events. So that means this involved this week is a roll up of linked events to a equation property from this week. So I'm guessing that's coming from this database, which it is. And nicely enough, you actually have a cool set of views here where you can see your weekly setup of, you know, what time do I have different events set? And I'm probably gonna try to take different parts of this and implement it into my own workspace. I think it's really cool that this guy's made something that's so simple, but so effective. And as somebody who uses Google Calendar and Notion all the time, that $50 in a year, it's gonna save me all the time in the world. And if you guys get it, it's probably gonna impact you at a huge level.
If you like this video, make sure to click on this one to see how you can improve your Notion even more.